Let's go.
No, let's see who's the real Annie Oakley here, I guess.
Ooh. Is that close?
Pull. I'm telling you, I'm hitting it every time. And that was a strikeout right there, if you didn't notice.
And we're back with Austin Dillon. Now, I have to admit, I was in Daytona when that feature aired, so I didn't see it. Did it make you just the least bit nervous that Danielle Trotta had a loaded firearm for the first time?
Well, I was the teacher, so I wasn't too nervous. I made sure I taught her well and make sure our gun safety was the biggest part of the whole teaching her how everything worked with guns, is make sure we had the safety on at all time, the barrel out in front of everybody. So she did a great job, taught her as much as I could about it, and me and Ty had a little competition at the end of the feature, and he actually ended up, I think, winning. He outdid me at the gun shooting part.
Is he a better shot than you are? Or...
No, he's not a better shot. He got me by one, I think, there. That was just his lucky day.
Spoken like a true brother. Now, you told me earlier you're taking one course at High Point University this semester, and it's a radio show. Tell me about it.
Yeah, on Monday nights I have my own radio show from 4 to 6 p.m. Eastern time. So having a lot of fun with it. Been having a few guests come on and working on getting a call-in kind of deal going. And I gave away a diecast last week through my Twitter and my Facebook on the radio show. So it's been exciting. You know, I'm learning a lot about it, what I don't like and what I do like. So communication business is it's a lot different than other businesses, I guess you could say.
Well, if you need me to guest, I'd be available. You know, I could call in. What's the name of the show?
It's the Country Boy Radio on HBUradio.com, and our show is Country Boy Radio.
Love it. 4 to 6 p.m.
Eastern. 4 to 6 p.m. Eastern time.
All right, now you're a young guy, still 20 years old. When you saw Trevor Bayne win the Daytona 500, what did you think about? I mean, did you see yourself in him, or what were your thoughts and emotions?
I felt like, you know, growing up racing in the East Series, we ran the series together. Me and Trevor both did. Ran for points. We had a really fun time racing each other. One of my good friends. So watching the race, I was cheering for RCR, cheering for our guys. And then when it came down to it, our guys kind of weren't in the mix there at the end, however it played out. But I cheered Trevor. Me and my brother were jumping up and down for him the last lap. Super excited for him. And he's a great kid. I've, like I said, I kind of raced with him as he kind of came up through the sport. And it's cool to see a guy that are young and can go out there and do it and prove that they can go and run in the Cup Series.
I talked to Landon Castle. He was here last week, and I talked to him yesterday at Driver Intros. And Austin, he said the same exact thing. He said, first of all, we're friends. He goes, but when I see Trevor win the Daytona 500, I see myself doing the same thing.
Yeah, Trevor did a great job. He played the race perfectly. He pushed all day. And when it came down to it, he found the lead, and he couldn't have played out any better for him. So just super proud of him, and it shows that guys like us that are young, up-and-comers, can go out there and run with those guys.
Hey, best of luck in Darlington in a few weeks and on the radio show. And I'm just saying, I'm available if you need somebody, you know,
hey,
fill a couple
I'll get
minutes.
You on there. We'll figure out a way to get you a call in, or heck, come down to the studio.